You call me a flight risk, try to close my eyelids and let the sound of water fill me from the bottom. Subscribe.
Five things that I wish I knew before I started computer science. These are genuinely things I wish I was able to go back and tell myself back when I first started, and this was a long time ago. Okay, so number one is that you should not wait for cool projects to start coming to you. You need to sort of go and find your own interest and then go into that interest on your own. Okay, I thought when I did my GCSE, you know, you compare your subjects to other subjects when you're starting out. You're like, okay, computer science, it's cool because you're going to make programs, you're going to make some cool websites. That never really happens at GCSE level, unfortunately. So I waited until the end of GCSE and I was like, okay, A-levels, come on, you know, let's do something a bit more complex than Hello World and five stars making a tree in the console. But no, nothing happened. It was the same thing pretty much until you get pushed into the self-learning phase where you're like, okay, now nothing's really coming out of class. I'm just going to make my own sort of project. I actually learned more before I did GCSE through just having fun and just looking for projects on my own. So don't wait for opportunities to come to you. Just go and open doors, create your own opportunities, and you'll have fun that way. Number two is that a lot of the material that you tend to learn at university, college, GCSE, A-levels, they're not really applicable to the industry. And there's a fine reason and explanation for this. It's that you're learning computer science, you're not learning software engineering, which is the typical role that a computer scientist may go down. And you have other roles as well, data science, but computer science is very different from software engineering. So whenever you have an internship, whenever you have a graduate role, there's often a very huge clash between what you've been taught and what you actually do in a day-to-day role. So that makes you realize that when you actually apply to this software engineering role, you shouldn't just rely on your degree, because that's computer science, not software engineering. Okay, so make your own projects, just join hackathons, work on open source, do all of these extra industry level certifications, and think about how are you actually preparing for an industry role, not just your degree. I like to think of it as a degree prepares you to do a master's and a PhD in computer science, but not to prepare you for the industry. Number three is to not limit yourself to a specific language. Now, you may be taught Delphi for your first year as an introduction course. You might be taught Java. And for the rest of your life, you may think, okay, this is the language I know, this is the language I'm best at, I'm going to stick to this. Okay, you think about certain projects you can do, you might look at Java and you can be like, okay, I can make an Android app now. And you limit yourself to the scope of what the language can do. Now, Java is very broad in what it can do, but you want to be able to start making websites as well, and HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and React, the library, all these sorts of avenues have so many other possibilities. So I like to come from it with a different perspective, and I'm like, okay, what do I want to do? What tooling is available? Ignore the language completely and then just choose the best tooling. So when I did my HoloLens project, I looked at the different SDKs and toolsets which were available. There were toolsets in HTML, JavaScript, you had C#, and me being a very heavily involved C# developer, I would have normally had that tendency, if I was in that situation, to go for the C# library and SDK. But I was like, you know, I'm just gonna choose the best toolset, no matter what language it is. I started off looking into HTML, JavaScript, and CSS. Eventually, I came across limitations with that. Don't limit yourself based on the language, okay? Number four is that specializing in one field does not mean that you are now limited to that field for the rest of your career. I think this is a common thing amongst many students where they're like, okay, I need to specialize. I'm in year two now. What am I going to be specializing in year three? What am I going to do for the rest of my life in my industry? I could choose cybersecurity today and I can go down that avenue and that rabbit hole and then get stuck in that avenue and never come out. Or you might be like, okay, I want to do AI, I want to do data science. Which one do I choose? IoT, data science. There's so many avenues in computer science. Right now, my Microsoft internship is in cloud, but I'm also doing mixed reality. I'm doing other things as well. I'm doing data, AI. So you sort of have to think on a broad scale as well that in cloud, there are many avenues. And that's the same thing with an AI. In AI, there is security. You learn different aspects. You are able to switch paths. And that's the whole thing I would also advise you to think about internships. You're at the beginning of your career. You have the opportunity to switch for the next 50 years. People job switch all the time. Jobs today, my role wasn't even available a few years ago. In the next 10 years, by 2030, you're going to have jobs such as augmented story, reality builder, you're going to have drone traffic optimizer. These sort of jobs do not even exist on the market. So how can you specialize in that field if they don't even exist? So you have to be flexible and remember that trying different things is fine. And yeah, don't feel like you have to be in a certain stream or certain speciality so early on in your career. You've got years ahead of you. Even if you're graduating, you've got years ahead of you. Number five is that college and university and this curriculum of learning isn't all that useless, because it gives you the structure to learning. It gives you this coherency to your daily plan, and it kind of forces you to do things which you don't enjoy doing. For example, you might not enjoy a certain module, you might not enjoy mathematics within computer science, but you'll learn that you don't like that. So you know that in your own spare time, you're not going to be focusing on math. You're going to be focusing on something else. Maybe you're into blockchain. It doesn't matter, but you know that you don't like something. Now you can focus your life on something else, your passions into some other area. And that's what I sort of think university acts as. It acts as it serves you stuff you don't like so that you look for areas you enjoy within the field. And yeah.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
But whatever it is, even if you don't enjoy it, put all that effort into whatever you're studying, because it might come in handy in a few years. You might be doing an internship and you might be like, wow, okay, if I paid a bit more attention in class back then, I could know this. I don't have to study about it now on the job. So you think about these things, just put all the effort you can into every subject. There's always a nice light. So I hope you enjoyed that. I've almost finished my milk. Leave a comment down below what you want to see next. Hit that subscribe button and the like button, and I will see you in the next one. Bye bye. Holy moly, smoky.